Hello, hello, welcome back everyone. Now the other day I got an invitation to attend an exhibition of embroidered handbags that promise to keep underprivileged girls in school. Quite an undertaking there, but I was intrigued to see what quality they were offering, and let me just say I am a little particular about what I hold on my arm, and these handbags really came up to my expectations. Beautiful designs, neatly crafted, a lot of attention to detail. Let me give you a little brief about the brains behind this project. BLISS, short for Business and Life Skills School, is a social enterprise that combines education and skills training for girls driven by poverty to pick either work or school, and BLISS offers them an innovative solution. The more you come to school, the more money you make. Lovely. Now this philosophy very much matched the sensibilities of designer Maryam Tahir Khan, and together they came up with Sozan Kar. I hope I said it right, Sozan Kar, which means skilled with the needle in Dari. Please welcome Saba Gul from BLISS along with Maryam Tahir Khan. Hello, good morning.
Hey.
How are you? Lovely to have you here. Beautiful bags, by the way. We are surrounded by all these beautiful bags. Saba, I'll start with you. The concept of BLISS, this is amazing. I mean, you thought that this is the way to make, you know, money for these girls who need to be educated and all. Please do tell us how it started.
So this is sort of a problem that's, you know, pervasive throughout South Asia and Africa. There's a lot of young people in the world, young underprivileged people who have to make a choice between work and school. So the problem that I saw was particularly in the city of Attock, which is an hour and a half from Islamabad, and it has a huge population of Afghan refugee girls. And these girls work at carpet looms for up to 14 hours a day. And so they're working full time on carpet looms, hand weaving carpets. And that means that there's no time to attend school. And it's not about the cost, the money that it takes to go to school, it's about the time as well. So the idea was that there should be a way to sustainably combine education and skills training in a way that not only teaches them a skill, but also gives them an income to sort of get them through that, you know, period of adolescence where they
but
can stay in school.
But why Attock?
It's
Are you
not,
from Attock?
I'm not. I'm actually not from Attock. And it's not that I sort of just had an epiphany and I decided to go to Attock. It's more that I heard a talk at my school. I was still in school then, I was doing my master's. And the founder's wife, the founder of an NGO that we are working with at the moment, because we don't own the schools, we are sort of a plug-in to schools.
Okay.
And so the woman who was the founder's wife, she gave a talk at my school, and I was very inspired by the work they were doing, and I wanted to visit the schools. So I, you know, decided to come to Attock and meet the girls, look at the schools, see their work. And I was very discouraged by some of the trends I saw there, the trend of sort of, you know, girls dropping out in higher grades. And so we decided to start a pilot there, got some funding, and just kicked off in Attock. And the idea is to obviously scale it beyond Attock and beyond Pakistan even.
But this is the first time that you are doing this.
This is the first
this
time
the first
I'm doing
exhibition.
This, yes.
Well then I must say that you were very lucky to have found Maryam, because these are beautiful. Maryam is the designer of these bags. We are going to, you know, show you some of the bags here. Maryam, like, these are your designs.
Yeah.
And why bags, by the way?
Well, I'm from NCA. I'm
okay.
A painter basically. But last year when I was approached by Saba and BLISS,
Maryam, louder.
I wasn't really doing much because I have a little son, so I was busy with him. But I was looking for a project, something meaningful to do also, and I needed an outlet for my creativity. And so when BLISS came along, I really felt compelled to join. And this has been a challenge because I've never really designed handbags before.
Right.
But it has been very interesting, and I think the outcome is quite good. So
well, I must say that whenever we do go handbag shopping, we almost have a design in our head and we never get to get it. But you were very lucky that you could actually utilize, you know, that thought process in
so,
bags.
Yes.
Because
so
how much of a collaboration did you both have to go through? I mean,
it has been a team effort, definitely.
Okay.
Because we couldn't have done this without each other. And I would come up with the designs and we would discuss, both of us. And then because we have to send these designs to Attock, and we have to make sure that the girls over there, they, you know,
understand
what it is all about. But we really wanted to incorporate their style of embroidering as well, because it is all about them.
Absolutely. And it should also seem that it has come from there.
Exactly.
Interesting, very nice. I'm going to show a couple of them more. So these are going to be sold here in Pakistan only?
Initially in Pakistan, we do plan on starting to, you know, find sustainable partnerships in the UK and the US, and we're talking to people at the moment. But we want to launch in Pakistan and sort of encourage the idea of, you know, supporting local brands.
Okay, so how does this work? Now, again, Sabah, I'll ask you. So the funds that you generate by the sale of these bags, where do they go and how does it work out?
So the idea is, I mean, so far we haven't really generated much funds. Our first exhibition was in Karachi about 10 days ago. But the idea is for us to reach that point of breaking even, where we can say that we're covering our costs and we are obviously funneling the profits back to the community. So, you know, once we've covered our costs, everything that's left over, which is the profits, goes back to paying the girls for their time. And if there's more left over in the future years, we plan to establish an education fund for the girls to send them on to higher education, the more brilliant of them to higher education. So the idea is to sort of keep funneling the funds back to the community and, you know, generate a sort of sustainable income stream for them.
Okay, once again, let me tell you what BLISS stands for, because this is all, I don't know, it's very blissful around me now. Okay, now BLISS is short for Business and Life Skills School. Yeah, this is what it is. And of course, we have actually, last night we put up a link of it on our Facebook page as well for TMS, so that, you know, people could actually go in and tell us. Now, how much of Mariam quality control went into it? Because I can understand, I can imagine the you know, the people that you are targeting for them to buy, they are going to be very finicky about what they are paying for.
We've used whatever we've used, it's 100% pure. Like the khadar, it's 100% cotton, and the leather is 100% pure. And the threads that we use, they're all color fast. So we make sure that we're giving people what we would want to buy ourselves.
And the detailing, like the one that is next to you, if you could show it towards the camera. And this cane thing, I am probably getting
this. This is cane and this is khadar. This is actually inspired by the Kashmiri carpets.
Okay.
And the line, this first line of handbags is dedicated to Pakistan, all regions.
All right.
So this is from Kashmir, that one is from Multan, and so on and so forth.
Lovely.
So.
And this, the cane things, everything, you got it made yourself?
Yes, actually,
well?
Sabah and I really worked hard on getting the perfect things for our bags. So this we got made in Lahore. And I think it was last month, actually.
Yeah, this is a recent design. There's a lot of, you know, there's a learning curve for us as well. So a lot of times a bag will get made. For example, this one is the Multani bag, and it would get made, and, you know, there'd be sort of details that just wouldn't be what we, like, you know, I want to say that if I see this bag, I'll pick it up and be happy to pay money for it. And we would make sure that we got the bag. So a lot of times the bag would get remade two times or three times.
Even the embroideries, actually, because we wanted the girls to you know, do it very neatly and perfect their craft, then only then we would really make the bags.
So did you consult, obviously, you know, the latest trends? You
of
probably
course,
had to
yes.
see, because again, the people who are going to be buying them are probably not going to be buying them for charity. They have to like it to buy it, you know.
That's what I had in mind. I would think, would I want to buy a bag if I saw this somewhere? So we definitely keep the trends in mind.
Okay, lovely, lovely. So these are the, you know, we are actually showing some visuals of these bags being made as we speak. Just I showed you this design. It's on air now. So you know exactly how.
And this sort of also tells you how we go through iteration. So this is an older design.
Yeah, I can see. Yeah.
And then we sort of, you know, remade this in another form.
Did these girls understand exactly, like, you know, why would somebody want embroidery on a bag? Okay, we can expect, you know, on a dress.
No, you know, the interesting thing is when I did a survey, I went to the community and I told them to sort of show me their craft, show me their skills, show me their embroidery, show me their work. They actually showed me a lot of work where the embroidery did go already on little cell phone cases, little pouches, little bags that they had made, even jackets that they had made with embroidery on it. And so they definitely understand the concept of, you know, marketing their work, but they're just not as sort of savvy with understanding urban demand or, you know, the design preferences of the urban market.
And so the
idea is the color combinations and everything. So the idea is for us to sort of guide them through that process. And when I remember when I first took the first bag that we had, or the first couple of bags, this is one of those pictures when I went back the first time with our handbags. The girls were really excited. I mean, for me, it was great just sort of seeing the smiles on their faces, and they sort of jumped out of their seats and they said, you know, this is our work. These are bags that we've made, and it's, you know, it's going to be sold. And This time when I went back, one of the women, the older women, said, can you give this back to me? What's this bag? And she said, will you give this to me? And I said, well, you know, it's a sample and we're going to sell it and give you the money. Mm. And she said, you know, I don't need the money. I don't want the money. Just keep the money, but give me the bag.
Because it was her, you know, hard work and labor gone into
but
it.
But I told her, well, what do you do with the money? And she said, you know, it gets spent on my children, like their education, their books and their, you know, stuff like that. And I said, well, isn't that better than owning a handbag? And she just thought about that for a second and then she said, you know, my kids will also use the bag.
All right. Okay, I guess that is how a lot of, you know, ladies in the urban cities should also think, because we end up paying a lot for a lot of designer bags, and that money could also be gone into, like these bags. I'm sorry, you buy them, but then you also at the end of the day, you know, okay, you spent whatever money that you did, but you are doing something as well, doing something good too. So Karachi is one place. How was the response in Karachi?
People loved the bags. Everyone who saw the bags loved the bags. Everyone didn't buy the bags. And I think, you know, our market is a niche market. They're not cheap bags because they are very high quality. There's a lot of work that goes into them. This bag, for example, would take 2 months for a girl to embroider because there's two sides and each side takes a month. So it's a lot of work. It's a lot of hard work and effort. And so these bags are not, you know, not sort of very cheap bags. Mm. And so everyone won't buy them, and that's fine. But everyone does love them. So we do hope to get a much better response in Lahore, I think, because people do tend to spend more money in Lahore.
Yeah, why not? And I'm sorry, well, not anything against any other people, but we also like to spend and feel good about it. So this, if this is for a good cause,
this is the perfect opportunity.
Perfect, yeah, it's a perfect combination. So Lahore, Islamabad maybe as well, there are a lot of foreigners there, that would be a good market.
Yeah, we do plan on holding an exhibition in Islamabad if we have pieces left over, which we might not, but what we plan to do after our first sort of like, you know, stream of exhibitions is find sustainable retailers, you know, retail partnerships. So there are some, you know, shops that we have in mind where we'd like to start stocking our bags, and then also start a system for online ordering where people from outside Pakistan can order them online.
I don't know, whenever I've and you both are obviously, you must have traveled as well, such bags are so in demand in the West. Whenever they see anything handmade, I mean, even if you're wearing some clothes, they see a little bit of kadhai and they say, is this handmade? They go all out for it. So there would be a great demand for these over there. Yes. So how about, you know, that would also generate more funds.
Yeah, definitely a lot more. We do plan to sort of use the concept of cost subsidizing where we're, you know, charging different prices in different markets according to buying power. So we do plan to go, you know, sort of expand to the US and charge different prices there, and it will be a lot more profitable for us. But it's a very new endeavor, and, you know, we're a very small team. We're literally three or four people in total. And so it does require, you know, sort of a bigger team and more funds and more work to launch in a new market.
Well, I hope that we have been of help in some way, because I think these are wonderful things. These bags are just wonderful, and again, it's the cause at the end of the day. And I understand that you also want to own something really nice when you're also giving money. So this is something worth it. The exhibition is on Saturday.
28th.
And if you could just give us very quickly.
It's Saturday the 28th of May, 4 to 8 p.m. And it's at Maisonette Luxury Apartments, which are right off of MMLM. You know where Pizza Hut is?
It's on Holly Road.
Yeah. Okay. Great. Of course, we are going to put up everything on our Facebook page as well. Go there and definitely get it. These are good. You will be the only ones, because these are not going to be replicated anywhere else. So you're going to have fun. Yeah. Thanks a lot, girls.
Thank
great
you.
Work. I love
Thank
the bags.
You. Thank you.